Hey guys, and welcome back to another Revit tutorial. Today we'll be modeling a twisted tower, the Cayan Tower in Dubai, which until a couple years back, I believe, was the tallest twisted tower in the world. It's about 306 meters tall and about 68 levels above ground, I believe, and that's the parameters we'll be modeling to. And it has a twist of about 90 degrees. So I'm going to show you how to model that really quickly and easily, how to model that mass, how to do the floors, and how to add a facade, a curtain wall facade to that. That is really kind of clean and neat and creates a really complex building in relatively short time. Before we get started, please leave a like and a comment if you enjoy this video. And of course, any comments, questions, or suggestions, please leave those below. And if you want to see more videos like this, please remember to hit that subscribe button and the bell to get notified. So let's get straight into it. First thing we're going to do is come to an elevation, doesn't matter which elevation, just double click one of those, and we're going to create all the levels. So I might actually just, we'll use this one here, select it, and if we come up to array, we want a total of 68 levels. And we've already got this one down here, so we just want to copy, actually I'll hit escape, yeah, just to make sure that's level 2. So we've got level 1, level 2. If we go to array and then change this number here to 67, because we want 68 in total and we already have level 1 here, and we want to move it to the last, so go from here, click here, and then just move it up so it's vertical. And then because we want it to be a total of 306 meters, I'm just going to type 302m and make sure last is ticked on. So it's going to put our last level at 306 meters in total, and hit enter. And then if we just zoom out and zoom into that top level, we can see there it's 306 meters. The level name isn't quite right, but we can change that if we ungroup, control Z, select that and make that level 69 like that, or roof, and that's all good. Now we can go into a plan and start modeling the building. So I'm going to go into the site plan, double click that, might just hide these, so select those, right click, hide and view elements, and we're going to go to our massing and site tab, in place mass, close this, and let's just call it Cayan Tower, and we're going to create a rectangle. I'm not sure the exact dimensions, but let's work to something like, let's say 60 meters. So if we pick the first point, and I'll just pick a second point anywhere here, hit escape, and then tab to select one of these edges, and then click this dimension and make that 60 meters. And then same here, just hover over one of these. You might need to tab until it highlights just that single line, then select it, click the dimension 60m for 60 meters, like that. And now we can select this, and I might actually, if I press WT, or if you come up to the view tab and do tile views, like that, you'll be able to see them all side by side. Might just close off the east view. So just to have a look at this in 3D view, what it's looking like. So we've drawn basically just this square on the lowest level. So with it selected, if you come up to create form and make sure you pick solid form, or you can also just pick the first button here, solid form. And we've created now a solid form. If we click into this view, just by clicking the tab up here, we can also now drag this top up all the way to the top. And you can see there that it's snapping to those levels. So we'll let it go at the top. And with it still selected, I'm just going to go to rotate and then click anywhere in here and then rotate, and then just type in, you can do this graphically and click wherever you want it to rotate to, or you can type 90, hit enter, and you get that nice 90 degree rotation like that. Finish mass, finish that, because we're done with the form at this point. And if we select this now, we can also mask the floors. So you select the mask, come up to mask floors, make sure you select the first level, and then come down to the last level and hold down shift before you click it, so it's selected them all. And now you can just click on any one of these boxes and it will check all of those levels on. Go okay. Now we've got all those floors in there. I might actually just close off the site plan because we don't need that anymore. We'll work in 3D view. So we have now our mass and our mass floors, and we want to just turn that into actual building geometry. So, you know, solid floors and solid walls. So the first thing we'll do, the floors, we can go up to architecture, floor by face. And you don't need to select them one by one. You can just do a window like this, a selection box across everything, and go create floor. You can always change the type here as well, but we'll stick to 150mm. It seems about right. Create floor. Like that. We've got floors in there. Next, we can apply our curtain system. So architecture tab, curtain system, and then just pick each of the four faces. So we've selected all four faces, and then we can go create system. We can look at playing around with the properties or the type properties afterwards to get that looking right. So create system. Give that a moment to generate. And once that's done, we now have a facade on the building. We can hide the mass. So massing and site, click here and go show mass by view settings, which should hide the mass object, mass form, and the floors. So now we're left with just the building geometry, and we can just play around with the size of these, of the curtain system, to get that looking right. And the way you do that is by selecting the curtain system, coming into edit type, and then playing around with grid 1 and grid 2 and the layout spacing and adjusting for mullion size for each of those. But we won't get into that right now. I'll just show you quickly how you would actually do that. Let's say grid 1 is typically the horizontal spacing. So if we make this, let's say 10 meters as an example, go apply, we should see the width of these panels increase or double like that, but we'll bring that back to, let's say, 5 meters. And then grid 2 is the vertical size of the panels, the vertical dimension. You can play around with those. This one, the vertical will be a little bit trickier because it's twisted. You might need to play around with layout in here, the distance, number, or spacings. Also the spacing there might need to change a little. But it might be worth, you might want to go like fixed number, for example, go OK, and then change the number here in the instance properties from 4. We can probably change the number of panels to something closer to like 68, I think we were. So, and then the justification and offset is also something that we need to play with because we're twisting the building and it's a bit more complex. There's a little bit of playing around here to get that looking right. But that's actually looking not too bad. There's a little bit, I guess the panels aren't aligning perfectly to the floors there. But if we were to adjust these, let's try that. Like that, for example, is already looking a lot better. Those panels are almost perfectly aligned to those floors. And then it's just a matter of just making sure that it's working throughout the entire building. But that's pretty much it. I hope that was helpful and helps get you started on creating and practicing some more complex forms and twisted towers and curves and things like that in Revit, because it's all, or most of it's possible. If you've got any comments, questions or suggestions, please leave those below. Hit that like button if you found that helpful, and make sure you do subscribe and hit that bell to get notified of future videos. Also check out the channel, there's heaps more video tutorials like this on there, and I'll be making more videos like this almost every day going forward. And yeah, I hope that helps. Let me know what you think below, and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye.